The ride-sharing service Uber has announced its plan for introducing flying cars named as VTOL in 10 years. VTOL is the abbreviation of vertical takeoff and landing. Uber published a massive 98-page white paper detailing its plan to launch an on-demand aviation service called Uber Elevate. According to Uber's plan, you can travel from San Francisco's Marina to work in downtown San Jose in only 15 minutes instead of 2 hours. And you could save nearly 4 hours round trip between São Paulo's city center and the suburbs in Campinas. And Uber's flying cars can reduce your 90-plus-minute stop-and-go commute from Gurgaon to your office in central New Delhi to a mere 6 minutes. Every day, billions of hours are wasted on the road worldwide. Last year, the average San Francisco resident spent 230 hours commuting between work and home. That is half a million hour of productivity lost every single day. In Los Angeles and Sydney, residents spend 7 whole working weeks each year commuting, 2 of which are wasted unproductively stuck in gridlock. In many global megacities, the problem is more severe. The average commute in Mumbai exceeds a staggering 90 minutes. For all of us, that is less time with family, less time at work growing our economy, and more money spent on fuel, and a marked increase in our stress levels. A study in the American Journal of Preventative Medicine found that those who commute more than 10 miles were at increased odds of elevated blood pressure. On-demand aviation has the potential to radically improve urban mobility, giving people back time lost in their daily commutes. Just as skyscrapers allowed cities to use limited land more efficiently, urban air transportation will use three-dimensional airspace to alleviate transportation congestion on the ground. A network of small electric aircraft that take off and land vertically, called VTOL aircraft, will enable rapid, reliable transportation between suburbs and cities, and ultimately within cities. The development of infrastructure to support an urban VTOL network will likely have significant cost advantages over heavy infrastructure approaches such as roads, rail, bridges, and tunnels. It has been proposed that the repurposed tops of parking carriages, existing helipads, and even unused land surrounding highway interchange could form the basis of an extensive distributed network of vertiports, that is VTOL hubs with multiple takeoff and landing pads, as well as charging infrastructure, or single aircraft verti stops. As costs for traditional infrastructure options continue to increase, the lower cost and increased flexibility provided by these new approaches may provide compelling options for cities and states around the world. Furthermore, VTOLs do not need to follow fixed routes. Trains, buses, and cars all funnel people from A to B along a limited number of dedicated routes, exposing travelers to serious delays in the event of a single interruption. VTOLs, by contrast, can travel toward their destination independently of any specific path, making route-based congestion less prevalent. Recently, technology advances have made it practical to build this new class of VTOL aircraft. Over a dozen companies with as many different design approaches are passionately working to make VTOLs a reality. The closest equivalent technology in use today is the helicopter. But helicopters are too noisy, inefficient, polluting, and expensive for mass-scale use. VTOL aircraft will make use of electric propulsion, so they have zero operational emissions and will likely be quiet enough to operate in cities without disturbing the neighbors. At flying altitude, noise from advanced electric vehicles will be barely audible. Even during takeoff and landing, the noise will be comparable to existing background noise. These VTOL designs will also be markedly safer than today's helicopters, because VTOLs will not need to be dependent on any single part to stay airborne, and will ultimately use autonomy technology to significantly reduce operator error. Uber says that in the long term, VTOLs will be an affordable form of daily transportation for the masses, even less expensive than owning a car. Normally, people think of flying as an expensive and infrequent form of travel, but that is largely due to the low production volume manufacturing of today's aircraft. Even though small aircraft and helicopters are of similar size, weight, and complexity to a car, they cost about 20 times more. Ultimately, if VTOLs can serve the on-demand urban transit case well, quiet, fast, clean, efficient, and safe, there is a path to high production volume manufacturing, which will enable VTOLs to achieve dramatically lower per vehicle cost. The economics of manufacturing VTOLs will become more akin to automobile than aircraft. Initially, of course, VTOL vehicles are likely to be very expensive. But because the ride-sharing model amortizes the vehicle cost efficiently over paid trips, the high cost should not end up being prohibitive to getting started. And once the ride-sharing service commences, a positive feedback loop can ultimately reduce costs and thus prices for all users. Uber report says that VTOL aircraft is achievable in the coming decade if all the key actors in the VTOL ecosystem, regulators, vehicle designers, communities, cities, and network operators collaborate effectively.